outgoing American ambassador to the United Nations, Nikki Haley, has slammed Pakistan for its failure to take control and giving a free hand to the terror groups who continuously wreak havoc in Afghanistan and is responsible for the deaths of many U.S. soldiers who are posted in the war-torn country. Newsweek South Asia has a report.
In a recent interview to a leading magazine, Nikki Haley, who is the outgoing American ambassador to the United Nations, said that the United States shouldn't even give a dollar to Pakistan. Being considered as the strongest attack on Pakistan for its negligence in controlling terror from its soil, Haley asserted that Pakistan should be given guidelines to handle terrorism before handing over any financial help to Islamabad. She said Pakistan should be told that they must follow those guidelines even before they help with military or start counter-terrorism.
The statement that is coming out from Nikki Haley in the United Nations is absolutely correct. Earlier also, President Donald Trump, when he was elected and he was going to take his oath, and straight away after that, he said the same thing, that Pakistan has been leading the United States of America up the garden path. The amount of billions of dollars that they have been giving Pakistan as support and for aid against terrorism, they have not utilized against that. They have not finished the support to the Haqqani network. They have not finished their support to Taliban. In fact, Pakistan has safe havens for the Haqqani network and Taliban.
Nikki Haley criticized the fact that US gave billions of dollars as aid and Pakistan continued to use those funds to train and provide resources to terrorist organizations. Haley added that the approach of foreign aid should be done in a more transactional way, which is by offering aid to those countries that show goodwill. Allowing the money to flow blindly without thinking the money was real leverage is something that the United States government ignored for years.
America, on its part, has been providing money to Pakistan for two reasons. One is for the logistic supply that the support that they are doing from their country. Second was to fight against the terrorism. Now, what Pakistan has been cleverly doing is they have been providing the support to America, but not going against the militants, not doing any action against the Taliban and the Haqqani network, not taking up any action against the militant leaders who are roaming freely in Pakistan. Now, this what is now bothering America, that look, after spending such a lot of billions of dollars that we have given to Pakistan as aid, these people have just not done anything to curb terrorism.
Nikki Haley's statement comes just a few weeks after United States President Donald Trump said in a statement that Pakistan does not do a damn thing against terrorism. Trump clearly conveyed that Pakistan has done little in spite of accepting aid from US to assist it in its war on terror, among other things. US's frustration with Pakistan has been expressed publicly by Trump administration many times. In Washington's political circles, Pakistan is widely seen as a major factor behind the Afghanistan war going downhill in the last two decades. The US has suspended $1.66 billion in security assistance to Pakistan following Trump's directive, the Pentagon has said, in what experts believe is a strong signal of American frustration.
Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan is certainly in a delusion state. First of all, his own party, the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Ittehad, its vice president is Hamid Gul, who was the founder of ISI of Pakistan, and he was also the founder of Taliban. Apart from that, the Haqqani network and whatever support he has been giving to the militant organizations in the Middle East, that has come up to the fore. Apart from that, Pakistan's Imran Khan's political party is in collaboration with Samiul ul Haq, who is the chief of Darul Ulum. And Darul Ulum, as you know, is the father of Taliban.
In a recent interview with the Washington Post, Prime Minister Imran Khan dismissed US's allegation that there were safe havens for terrorists in Pakistan, saying that the security forces had briefed him on the matter and told him that they had asked Washington time and again to point out where the sanctuaries were. The Prime Minister also said he would never want to have relations with the US, where Pakistan is treated like a hired gun. Pakistan needs to get a reality check, as most of the terror outfits which are active throughout the world originate from Pakistan and get resources, training from Pakistan government, its army and intelligence agency, the ISI. Be it the Taliban, Haqqani Network or the Lashkar-e-Taiba, all have terror bases in Pakistan.